We're heading to Blackrock, where the Blackrock Rejuvenation Project is underway. It will greatly improve the environment and infrastructure of the eastern seafront. It will also provide upgrades, promoting greener travel and improved connectivity between the eastern seafront, Blackrock and Brighton Marina. The council is leading this scheme with funding from Coastal Capital Local Enterprise Partnership. I'm meeting with Carol Homewood, our local historian, to find out more about the history of the area. Carol, you've taken us to Blackrock Station this week. Now, ever since I've come to Brighton, I've heard the words Blackrock and vaguely understood it to be an area around Brighton Marina. Tell us a bit more, because are we in Blackrock at the moment?
We're almost near it. I mean, this is Blackrock Station here, the end of the Volks Railway. So the whole area of the marina and the site of the original Blackrock swimming pool, which is just over here, was the area known as Blackrock, or still is.
And why was it called that?
Why was it called Blackrock? It was a lot of theories of why it was called Blackrock. One is because of all the rock pools that were below. Obviously, people come here doing crabbing and shrimping. But the other thought is that we had the gasometers up, which are still up there, but not used anymore. The gasometers were there, and coal brigs would come along the sea, along the coast, and bring coal, offload it at the beach, and then there was a tunnel that they would have carted it up through the tunnel up to the gasometers. Obviously, the coal being black rock. But the other theory that I have read about, and probably most likely, was from Jeff Mead, geologist, a local historian, who reckons that it was probably named after sarsen rocks that they found in the cliffs, but also the whole area above was known as Blackrock Down long before the gasometers came along.
Because this is a very ancient part of Brighton, isn't it? The rocks here have been, I mean, there's signs of mammoth activity here in the cliffs as well.
Yeah, apparently so.
This is a clearer view of the site of the old Blackrock pool.
That's right, yeah.
And this is the Blackrock Rejuvenation Project in action at the moment, with a new access road from Brighton to Brighton Marina.
Yeah.
Yes, tell us a bit more about this area.
Blackrock Pool was the place to go sort of in the 70s. You'd go there with your parents, and all I remember of it was a massive pool, which I couldn't swim, so it was always very scary, but I used to go in there and just hang on to the bars. But the little kids' pool, really, I remember most. But also my other memories are my parents bringing lunch, packed lunch down, which would be a bottle of orange squash and sandwiches, which were always really warm and disgusting by the time you got round to eating them. And you'd be wandering around the pool and you'd be treading in all these remnants of people's soggy sandwiches. That's my biggest memory of Blackrock, really. But it was a great place to go. So it opened in 1936, so a year after the Rottingdean pool, which was further along. And then a couple of years later, the Salt Dean Lido opened. So you had three pools going on at the same time, really. And they opened it, the council opened it, but they weren't sure it was going to work. So they kind of just testing the water with it, thought it might be a bit of a white elephant at the time. And of course, 3 years later after it opened, World War II happened. So they had to close it. So from Blackrock, apparently, right down to Worthing, all the beach, it was a no-go area for people. So the pool was closed, and they used the pool for waterproofing testing of the tanks, apparently, in World War II. It reopened in 1946. Okay. And then after that, obviously, it was really popular place. And I think 1 year they had about 150,000 visitors in Goodness. 1 year, which was great for Volks Railway as well.
So did the Volks Railway run all the way to Blackrock?
It did run further at one point, but I presume when the pool was built, that it was pushed back a bit, because it did come further this way. And I'm not sure which year it actually was pushed back further. But it wouldn't be great access for people coming to Blackrock Swimming Pool to get vaults. It probably was a boom period for them at the time. It was a really popular place. You'd have had beauty contests there. You'd have had water polo trials going on there, life-saving events going on, all sorts of things going on at the pool. Really, really popular. And you get to the 70s, and obviously Brighton Marina comes along, and they were talking of saving the pool. Councillors wanted to save it, but apparently it was going to cost too much money, so they decided to demolish it. And of course, the marina was built, thoughts of replacing it with something else afterwards, which never materialised. As we know, it's been a wasteland for the past 40 years, and now they've just started to, you know, develop the area. So we'll see what comes next.
How do you feel about the new rejuvenation project?
Well, any rejuvenation is good around Brighton, isn't it? So, yeah, I'm all for it. I mean, it was a bit of an eyesore, really, just the derelict site. You know, it'd been better to have left the building intact and let us look at that for another 40 years rather than nothing. Though we had sand sculptures here a few years ago, about a decade ago.
Forward to a rejuvenated Black Rock. We've got the saltine lido that's been rejuvenated.
Oh my god, that's amazing.
We have the sea lanes. So do you want another pool back here in this area?
It would have been lovely, but of course we've got sea lanes. But you know, see what the guys did at saltine lido. They fought to save it, and they did, and now it looks amazing, and they have all sorts of events there as well. So good for them. You know, they really fought hard to save it, and it's a shame at the time, back in the 70s, we didn't fight harder to save Black Rock. But we didn't.
So you're very much about saving what was the best about old Brighton?
Well, you know, if we can, yeah. I mean, sometimes we can't, and sometimes it's not worth saving. But, you know, when buildings are worth saving, it's good to at least try. You know, 1930s architecture is always a good thing in my book.
And there's also a network of tunnels, it appears, underneath this area, underneath the cliffs, the famous tunnel.
Yeah, so that little tunnel... The rumour is that Lewis Carroll wrote Alice in Wonderland and based the rabbit hole on going through that tunnel. He used to stay in Sussex Square with a friend. So apparently that's the rumour. Whether it's true or not, I don't know. But yeah, we like to believe that's real.
Talked about Blackrock, the old pool that was on this site that is now the site of the Blackrock Rejuvenation Project, but there's still so much history in this area. For instance, Daddy Longlegs. Lots of people in Brighton have heard of the Daddy Longlegs but don't know much about it. Can you tell us a bit about what that was?
Yeah, so it's all part of Magnus Volks's idea that he wanted to run a train from here to Rottingdean. So he came this far to Passon Place originally. He got as far as Passon Place with his railway and, of course, couldn't go any further because we've got a few cliffs in the way to get to Rottingdean. So he thought, oh, we'll build a train going through the water. So he built the Daddy Long Legs, which was, on stilts with a carriage above. And it went from Passon Place all the way to Rottingdean and back. And that was part of the railway. It didn't last very long. Of course, it opened in 1896 when the chain pier was destroyed. And literally, that storm did a lot of damage to the Daddy Long Legs at the time, and it got knocked over into the sea, so that caused a lot of damage there. They got it up and running again, but it only survived another 5 years or so because they had to build all the groins for sea defence. And of course, Daddy Long Legs couldn't go through it. So it was removed.
How did it move?
It moved on rails, but electricity as well. So you had these electricity poles, and it went across these big stone blocks with rails on top. Pretty amazing. I don't think I'd have attempted it, but how amazing it would have been to see it at least. So that ran all the way through where the marina is now, all the way to Rottingdean. At very low tide, you can still see the blocks, the concrete blocks. And at Rottingdean end, you can still see some of the wooden poles that would have held the cables. It's sad that went, but I'd love to see it rebuilt at Passon Place and as a museum for everybody, but I don't think that's ever going to happen.
Well, Carol, thanks for enlightening us on some more of the rich history of Brighton, and we look forward to the new Blackrock Rejuvenation Project.
Thank you.
Thank you.